Hello everyone. Thank you so much for joining this session on how to build a RAG-based generative AI chatbot in 20 minutes using Amazon Bedrock knowledge bases. I'm Fraser Sequeira, a startup solutions architect at AWS. So let's get started. To equip a foundation model with up-to-date proprietary information, organizations turn to retrieval augmented generation. It's a technique that involves fetching data from company data sources and enriching the prompt with that data to deliver more relevant and accurate responses. Knowledge Bases for Amazon Bedrock is a fully managed RAG capability that allows you to customize foundation model responses with contextual and relevant company data. Knowledge Bases automates the end-to-end RAG workflow, including ingestion, retrieval, and prompt augmentation, eliminating the need for you to write custom code to integrate data sources and manage queries. Session context management is built in, so your app can support multi-turn conversations. All the information retrieved from knowledge bases comes with source citations to improve the transparency and minimize hallucination. Let's now head to the AWS console to build our RAG application. Here, within the AWS console, we are on the Amazon Bedrock service page. Amazon Bedrock offers a diverse range of foundation models, accessible via a single API, without you having to host them on GPUs. With Bedrock, you just pay for the input and output tokens consumed as part of your request. You can click on Model Access and go through the list of models available on the Bedrock platform. Once access has been granted, you can then head to the Bedrock Playground mode and try out these models. You can also compare various foundation models on the Bedrock platform. Let's start with an example. Let's select Anthropic Claude 3 Sonnet, and we could choose another model. Let's go with Anthropic Claude 3 Haiku. And let's try out a prompt. Okay, so Haiku gave us a quick response, and then Sonnet came back later. Here we can see details on the input tokens consumed, the output tokens, and the latency. Similarly, we have the same metrics for Haiku as well. Now that we understand a bit about the Bedrock platform, let's build our RAG application with Bedrock Knowledge Bases. For that, you would need to click here on Knowledge Bases. Now here we have an option to chat with your document, which you could explore on your own. But our goal is to build a production-ready application where we have millions of documents that need to be searched and summarized. So for that, let's click on Create Knowledge Base. Now let's build a tax advice bot. So let's give our knowledge base a name, tax advice. Adding a description is optional, but let's add a description here. This KBase contains some tax-related data. The next is IAM permissions. You would need to create a service role if you have not created one previously. This is for Amazon Bedrock to access services and APIs on your behalf. Now we can select the default option here, create and use a new service role. Next, we need to choose our data source. Now we have a wide variety of data sources that we can choose from. But for this example, let's stick to S3. So I have all of my tax related data in an Amazon S3 bucket. You have options to tag and set up logging for your knowledge base here. Let's hit next. Here we configure data sources. We can attach up to 5 data sources with a single knowledge base. Here I'll select my S3 bucket that contains all the tax related information. Once we've done that, we then need to configure a chunking and parsing strategy. We could just go with the defaults or customize it as per our use case. Bedrock offers a parsing strategy to extract tabular data to keep it intact, and you could select a foundation model for doing so. It also offers a chunking strategy. Let's pick the fixed chunking strategy here, and let's select max tokens as 500 and a chunk overlap percentage of 10. This overlap maintains some context and continuity between chunks. You could further customize the chunking behavior and the document metadata processing in a Lambda function and attach it here. The next thing to do is to select an embeddings model. There are multiple options available here. Let's go with the Embed English V3 model by Cohere that offers 1024 dimensions. Now this model will create the embeddings for our data, which will then be chunked and stored in our vector database as per our configuration. So the next step is to select a vector database where we store these embeddings. Vector databases store numerical representation of our data, and this allows them to perform similarity searches on our stored documents. Here we will go with the quick create option. An Amazon open source serverless vector collection is created on your behalf. There are also other options that you could explore. We support third-party vector databases as well, such as Pinecone, MongoDB, Atlas, Redis Enterprise Cloud. Now let's click Next and review our KBase configuration. After you've validated the configuration, you can click on Create Knowledge Base. Now, depending on which vector database you've chosen, it would take anywhere between 30 to 50 minutes to set up your knowledge base. Here, I'll pause the video and get back when my knowledge base is set up. So here, we have knowledge base created. It roughly took around 10 minutes to create this knowledge base. Now, let's look at what all Bedrock has created for us. So the first thing that we can look at is the Amazon open source serverless vector database here. So Bedrock has created a serverless vector collection for us. Let's review that. Let's go to Amazon open source service. And here, let's look at serverless collections. Now here we have a Bedrock knowledge base. Let's click on this. Actually, let's click on the OpenSearch dashboard. And let's see if we have some data here in our vector database. So let's just fire this default query and see if it returns any results. So right now, we do not have any data in our vector database. Now let's go back to our knowledge base and let's click on the radio button next to our S3 data source. Let's click on sync. Syncing should take anywhere from a couple of minutes to a few hours, depending on the number of documents in your S3 bucket. Here we have roughly 5 to 6 documents, so syncing should be faster. During the sync process, Amazon Bedrock Knowledge Base is fetching the data from the S3 bucket. It's then chunking the data as per our defined chunking strategy and then passing those chunks to our embedding model that's generating embeddings for our data. Once the embeddings are generated, it's then stored in our Amazon open source serverless vector collection. So syncing the S3 data with the vector database took around 5 minutes. We can check the sync history by clicking on the data source and it tells you that we had 6 source files, 1 failed and 5 were added. We can further investigate the failed reason by clicking on View Warnings. We can retry the sync once we've fixed the issue. Now let's quickly head to our vector database and confirm that the data exists in there. So here let's click on our vector collection and let's go to Indexes. Here we have roughly 38 MB of data in our vector database and around 2000 chunks indexed. We can further check the configuration of the index created by the Bedrock Knowledge Base. So here, we can click on the index and look for additional configuration. So here we have more information. It's using files for nearest neighbor search. It's using a Euclidean distance type and the vector field has 1024 dimensions. Similarly, we have some additional metadata in here along with their data type. So it stores the source URI of the document, the page number, a unique ID and much more. If you intend to deep dive, you could verify the data by going to OpenSearch dashboards and firing the default query. As you recall, previously we didn't have any data in here, but now that we have ingested documents through Bedrock Knowledge Base, we can see our chunked and embedded data in here. This is our vector field on which similarity searches will be performed. And this is our passage or chunk that's used for source citations by the knowledge base. Now that we see the data in here, it's time to put our knowledge base to the test. So let's head back to our knowledge base and let's select a foundation model. In this case, let's go with Claude 3 Haiku. As you can see, it's giving me relevant data. It's also giving me source details, which is very important for provenance, which is important especially in legal and finance domains. So here we have source details and the metadata associated with the chunk. Here we can also see from which document this chunk or this data was summarized. In order to build a chatbot using Bedrock knowledge bases, you would have to interact with knowledge base APIs. The two prominent APIs that you would have to interact with is the Retrieve API and the Retrieve and Generate API. The Retrieve API is solely responsible for fetching the documents, fetching the data from your vector database, whereas the Retrieve and Generate API is responsible for fetching the data from the vector database as well as passing on that information to a foundation model and generating the response from that model and giving you the final output. Hope you enjoyed tuning in. That's all for today's video. Thanks for watching.